Katrina Du, welcoming you into Step Into the Valley with the 3-Step Realty Group. Today, we're going to talk about knowing your buying power when you're out purchasing a home. Now, the first thing of knowing your buying power is to know how much home you can actually afford versus how much home do you want to afford. What does that mean? Okay, so when you go and you talk to your local lender professional, they're most likely, this happens to most people, are going to tell you qualify for this much home. And then when you find out what the monthly mortgage payments are for this much home, you may go, oh, I'm not really comfortable with paying that much a month in mortgage. So then you bring it down to what you actually can afford or what you're comfortable with, what I call your budget. Now, that's the pre-qualification phase of knowing your buying power. The next step is going through your full pre-approval process. The difference between pre-qualification and pre-approval is a pre-qualification is generally just a lender's opinion based off of what the buyer has told them, how much they make, what's in their bank accounts, and what they think is on their credit report. Where the full pre-approval process is the lender actually collecting all of that documentation to back up what the buyer tells them, run their credit report, and put them through the system for a pre-approval process, or sometimes fully underwrite up front. Now, why it's really important to keep going all the way through the pre-approval process is because sometimes there has happened, buyers might not know that something that has actually on their credit report and it surprises them. And at that point in the process, their heart is set on buying a home and moving forward, only to find out that they have to wait a little bit to fix what they didn't realize was on their credit report. So knowing ahead of time is really gonna help you. The other reason why you wanna make sure you have your pre-approval process done is because when you're out looking at homes and you're ready to write that offer, you can do it really quick rather than having to go back to your lender saying, we need to get the pre-approval done. I have come across some people that say, we wanna wait for that perfect home before we get our pre-approval done and the credit ran. What has happened is they get their heart broken because they found that perfect home and they missed out on the opportunity because someone else put the offer in while they were getting their pre-approval done. Don't let that happen to you. Now, you wanna fully understand what your buying power is. Now, it's not only what you want to afford or your budget in a home, but it's what loan program that you choose. Most people typically qualify for more than one loan program. So it's about talking to your lender or your loan professional about what loan program works best for you. It's really important to make sure that you have your full buying power, your pre-approval, the loan program ready to go before you go out looking. That way, you can make sure the home that you're looking at qualifies with your buying power. That means not only is it within a home that you want to afford, but some homes don't qualify under certain loan programs. So we want to know that up front so we can make sure that you're looking at all the homes that fit within your buying power. And then you can also write an offer as quickly as you can when you find the one you fall in love with. The only way to fully know and go through that process of knowing your buying power is to talk to your lender or your loan professional. If you don't already have a relationship with someone, give us a call here at the 3-Step Realty Group. We'd be happy to introduce you to a few of our preferred loan professionals for you to choose from.